So the fifth principle, she should always wish all good to her husband. Need to know that the Vedas describe many types of prayers and different austerities that the woman undergo for the good of her husband, so that her husband will flourish, so that he will be healthy, everything will be all right with his job. Is it working? What do you think? It has enormous power. It is working 100%. The Vedas say if the woman wants, the powerful lady who is able to lift the weight about whom we were talking about, but not the one who unable to lift even a small weight to think that her husband is the best, means this woman has a very weak mentality. The woman who really has got the power, she will have a certain mood, will chant a certain prayers, depends on her faith. She will act in this way in relation to her husband. Everything will start changing in his life. Why this happened? Because the man who believes in his power, he is relaxed. What is the tiredness of the man? The tiredness of the man always means that he ceases to believe in his power. This is his fatigue. Because what purpose the man acting in this world? He proves his power to everyone, whether at home or out there, there is no difference. But the difference is that in his external activities he spent his energy, and at home he accumulated it. And if the wife creates at home such an atmosphere that he not need to spend his energy, he's already the most important person there. In other words, he's accumulating his power at home. The more so, she chants certain prayers for the success of her husband. He becomes in his external activities like a lion, but at home he appears like a lamb, you understand? Like a lamb. And when the family acting in this way, follow this principle, then in reality, anybody who wants to have something from this man, this person, need to say something good about his family. That's it. If the family is good, that is enough. Not need to convince him. Just a hint that you have a good family, I'm very astonished, that is enough to change the mood of the man. I'll give you one example. One sage decided to see the king. He wanted to have an association with the king. He sat down before the palace gates and started to glorify the king. Of course, the servants informed the king, so he glorified the king for the whole week and no any changes. And after that, another sage said to him, "What are you struggling for? Why don't you just start to glorify his wife? They have a good relationship, it is a good family, he respects her very much. Start to glorify his wife." He started to glorify his wife, the king immediately was informed, and the king started to think, "What is it? He knows too much about my wife. What is it?" And he immediately went out. The king went out and had association with the sage. You can see. The woman has a wide access into the database of her husband, and through her, all the relatives and close persons can resolve their issues. Not need to disturb the man in this case, everything resolves very easily. Of course, we have another lecture on this topic. I have described all the other responsibilities of women on those lectures. Since here I see many new people came. But I cannot describe everything today, of course, we have little time.
Поэтому я не могу, конечно же, у нас мало времени все рассказать.
Also, I need to know some moments which I want to explain. The woman in the family relationship has to develop an intuition. It is not difficult for her to do. For example, the woman should learn how to recognize the mood of the husband by the sound of the doorbell. Try to do it 3 times and you will be able to recognize. Raise your hands, ladies who already without training able to recognize simply by doorbell or by footsteps the mood of the husband. Not so many. I was thinking will be more people. Actually, it is not difficult for women to do. He rings and you understand. Just need to tune yourself to the doorbell and think what is the mood of the husband. What you need to do so? Why you need to do so? I will explain. When you see he's got a bad mood, what you need to do in this situation? Need to prepare yourself. Your internal woman's strength you need to prepare. Let's say the woman knows for sure that her husband has a bad mood. He will get angry. She opened the door to him and immediately make off. And he's saying, "Where are you go?" She's saying, on the kitchen, I'm cooking for you, didn't finish yet. She already finished everything. She laid the table already, but the man, you know, he needs to take it out on somebody to clarify the relationship. Where he will go? On the kitchen, he will go to the kitchen. When he will come to the kitchen, what you need to do? Need to say, sit down, my dear, on the chair, eat, take a spoon, eat, my dear. As soon as the man take a food into his mouth, that's it, you can relax. You can relax, everything is made already. You shouldn't give him opportunity to talk before he start eating. You understand the principle. The man loses his ability to be angry when he is satisfied. And if in this satisfied condition he start to be angry, it is very easy to pacify him. But if he is hungry, remember, ladies, don't mess up with the hungry man. The hungry man, that's it, he cannot control the situation, just in emotions. It is better not to mess up with him, need to feed him at this time. It is important to understand this idea. What else important? How to accumulate the strength, ladies? How should the woman work on herself? As usual, we were talking about how to work on yourself. First of all, need to turn on the music at home, the voice of the saintly person to purify the consciousness. This is the first. The second, not need to think that the close people owe me something. Not need to think of them as myself, consider them as a part of myself. Need to detach yourself from this idea. Need to think that actually they have their own life, they are on their own. Of course, they are my relatives, they are mine, but actually, if they behave not like supposed to be, it is not their fault. This is my problem, my personal problem. She should think this way. She should try to learn how to live a life properly. Generally speaking, the woman's idea of work on herself, it is a ritual. She should conduct some rituals, she should every day chant some prayers, she should do every day some kind of gymnastics, she should wake up at the right time to eat properly. All this gives strength. The mode of the day, nutrition, the chanting of some prayers. She should cut down the unwanted association. Now I will explain what does it mean. If you have a girlfriend who always criticizes her husband, you should always say to her that you've got a headache and you cannot meet her. You need to isolate yourself from the unwanted association. For the woman, it's the most important to keep the family, and through this, all kinds of happiness coming into her life. If somebody took over her husband from your girlfriend, this is a walking death. Walking death is a sign. Therefore, under no circumstances, you should associate with those women. You have to isolate yourself. If you will try to prove something to her, anyway, you will spoil your understanding of things. Now, those women who were listening attentively, not like this were listening, but very attentively, with a deep desire to understand what kind of alien knowledge is this, where it come from. Everyone say the opposite, actually, that need to say, I love myself. That's what the modern psychology recommend. You need to feel yourself as a person, you need to love yourself as your own self. So the modern psychologists say like that. And here it is totally opposite point of view, incomprehensible. You know, people living with this now, they want. What is the people's idea now? How the false ego works? It goes without a saying that you need to love yourself. It goes without a saying. Therefore, the modern psychology work in this direction. If this goes without a saying, then you will understand even better. But this falsehood. Actually, the true ego exists as well. The person should have dignity, self-respect. The woman who behaves like this, as I've described, does she have a dignity or not? Most of the women on this lecture think that she does not, but I will prove that she does. I will prove it now. You can prove it in different ways. First of all, how the other women will relate to her. Let's say the woman arguing with her husband. Will she inspire some real respect from the other women? No, they will think that this woman behaved rather badly. If the woman is able to behave properly in the family and, let's say, her girlfriend come around and see, oh, in my girlfriend's home everything is so good and the husband is satisfied and the children is happy and she is so humble, she thinks, she is a strong person, I cannot behave myself so. She won't think that her girlfriend is a weak person, 100%. The woman who behaves so and see that everything is going right, does she consider herself a weak person or not inside of her? No, she considered herself as a strong person. She feels the strength within herself. But she shouldn't tell anybody that she is the strong person. That is the secret. She has to tell everybody that she is a weak person, and to her girlfriends too. She should say like this, I am a good-for-nothing person, I am a weak person. She should say like this. At the same time, when she go at work, how she should behave? She should behave like a mother. She shouldn't behave like a wife there on work before the man saying, I'm so weak. There is not any place for weaknesses in this situation. The woman changes her behavior. With the husband, one way of behavior, with her friends another, and the same style of behavior at work. The woman behaves there like a mother. She has her self-respect. No one has the right to manipulate her. She will not behave as a wife before any other man. Let's say she is a secretary and working for the boss. Must she behave before him like a wife? Walk before him on tiptoe, etc.? No, she just behaves with dignity, perform her duty. If he say there, bring me this, does she bring? Yes, she bring, but she doing this with a cold mind. She doesn't have emotions. She brings something and go away. Will such a boss respect this girl or not? The foolish person will fire her out. And why need to be the secretary of the foolish person then? But the intelligent boss will respect her. He will say, I have a good educated, very intelligent woman. The intelligent person will say like that. Therefore, the woman who behave out of home in such a way, she do not look on anybody, do not flirt with the man, she behave herself evenly with the self-confidence, she inspire a strong respect in everybody. There is no doubt about it. And when at home she behaves humbly with her husband, even more respect means a rationality. Now let's think how the man's intelligence is manifested. Is it possible for the man to have an intelligence? Is it possible? I know this for sure. And it is manifested in responsibility. The man's intelligence manifested itself in responsibility. If the man behave responsibly, he do what he say, the man's intelligence manifested in this way. The woman's intellect is manifested itself in the humility, not in responsibility. The woman saying, if I say something, I will do it. This is a manifestation of foolishness. This is not the woman's intellect taking place. This is a foolishness is manifested so. We're talking about the family relationship, of course. Not in life, but in the family relationship. The woman should say the things humbly. Humility means the woman's intelligence. If the woman manifests the intelligence, she also can develop the intelligence in her husband. All the people have intelligence. Just some people have a strong intelligence, some people don't. So, with her humility, the woman able to change the man's intelligence. Let me think, didn't I miss something important in this lecture? The woman should look attentively for the changes in the mood of her husband. She can do it in any place, in any room. As soon as she feels some anxiety within herself, this means her husband get into a bad mood. How the woman should work on the relationship within the family? She should never point out the defects in a relationship to her husband and to her children as well. She never do that. If, for example, the children are naughty, she come into her husband and say, you know, I cannot do anything, please help me. You are very smart and strong, fine fellow. Do something with your son, please. Tell him. But with the daughter, she work herself. With the daughter, she work herself. She not asking husband, but the son should train through her husband. She shouldn't herself put her hand This means that she manifests her weakness and she doesn't have a respect for herself. When the mood of her relatives changes, she should start to repeat, I wish happiness to everybody, I wish happiness to my husband. She has to repeat this phrase, this formula. Since her mind is more stronger, as a result, his mind becomes peaceful. Maybe he has a problem, but not in the sphere of family relationship. The man can has a different relationship with different people, but this sphere of family relationship is situated at the mercy of karma of the woman. She work off her karma there. Therefore, when she feels that his God is something unpleasant towards her, some thoughts, she has to start to wish the happiness to him, ask for forgiveness, and this way she control the situation. This situation changes only with the help of quiet, unnoticeable struggle. This struggle is going on with her own self. So the woman wish the happiness, she trying to adjust herself positively towards him always in any situation of life. He was unfaithful, for example, doesn't matter. Anyway, she's trying to adjust herself positively to defeat her bad karma. Gradually, the strength will increase and increase. I came here for the first time 5 years ago in Dnipropetrovsk, or 4 years ago. Four and a half. And is there anyone who totally changed their lives? One person. The other are afraid to put the evil eye on. Four, five. Raise your hands, those who doesn't get any result. Is there any woman who doesn't get any result? Silence. And who has got the change for the better? Already more. And who didn't react at me at all as we're leaving us before? What's the problem? Nobody. Need to know that the family karma is the most heavy. In reality, if the woman start to work on herself, the changes will take place in 1 year time. The changes will begin in 1 year time approximately. Before that, nothing will happen. Because the family karma the most heavy. In order for strength to be manifested, I will list once again the basic principles. The main principle is the sound. The Vedas say the sound gives the power. This strength is situated in intelligence. This strength is called inspiration. Without inspiration, nothing changes. In order for inspiration to take place, need to listen to the voice of the saintly person or the spiritual music. Need to listen to something that inspires. Through the sound, the purification of intelligence take place. The intelligence affect the mind. That's how the life of the person changes, with the help of the sound. Now, you listen to me, and who listen attentively, those women get inspiration. The rest of people didn't get inspiration, even if you knew already what I were talking about. There is people who've been here 4 years ago, 2 years ago, and now. Why? All this is already known. They come in order to get strength, inspiration. That is the principle of Vedic knowledge. Even if the person already know everything, he should listen again and again about the same things in order to get again the strength. That is the strength that is necessary to change his life for better through the listening process. That is the principle. Those women who came and didn't believe me, this lecture appeared to them as some kind of foolishness. That is not possible. It is not possible. This foolishness. It's not happened like this. Don't be despaired. Come to this lecture again and gradually the reality will come into your head. Or into my head your reality will come. About which I have strong reservations. Anyhow, come just in case. Come to this lecture again. Gradually you will see that there is some very important moments of the truth in what we are talking about. Although I've told you a very high standard, actually, ladies, in reality little of you. I've told you those standards in which your life can become absolutely happy. But you should know, if you don't know how you will be, you should know what to aspire for. When the person knows what to strive for, then all he needs is to achieve that. In general, most of the people, they don't even know how to act, what is their strength consist of. People are struggle desperately, they don't know where is their strength situated, and as a result, all their life is passing by in this stupid struggle, which is destroying all their possibilities. And the people are falling apart, and their families are falling apart as a result. Any comments or questions? Please write a short letter and pass it to me. The man should not write about the women in these letters, and the women should not write about the men. The ladies should write about themselves. If the woman asking, if my husband such and such, this means the lecture is not understood. It is not important what kind of husband. If I don't have a husband right now, how to work off karma? Question. So with former man to work off karma. The woman without husband should be engaged in spiritual practice all the free time. She has to choose some spiritual path and she has to pray and change herself. The woman without husband can work off her karma in relation to God or with the absolute truth, whatever she is up to. If she, let's say, the communist, may she work off her karma with the light future. To believe, to work, to think about the light future. Nothing ridiculous, actually. There is a sense to that, because everybody has their light future, just we don't know what it consists of. What is the meaning of life? Everyone has his own meaning of life, and there is a supreme meaning of life, but what is the point to talk about this on this lecture? The supreme meaning of life is to realize the supreme. The supreme love, the supreme happiness, the supreme relationship are situated in the sphere of relations with God. Everyone has his own spiritual path, but the ultimate result will be the same, always. This lecture had a purpose in order for the person to make the first step in achieving the happiness. The work on yourself begins in a sphere of work with the heavy karma, most heavy, because this is a vital question, it is the most painful, and the person should try his strength there. Sometimes there are people who quit their families and think that now they are able to practice spiritual life, to work off their karma seriously. How the person can fight if he ran away from the battlefield? He already the deserter. How he can fight with his fate? In reality, when the person has this heavy relationship difficulties, in this situation he is indeed able to be engaged in self-perfection, otherwise inevitably he faces defeat. Let's say the woman was left alone, nothing terrible, need to pray to God, perform austerity. What do you think of woman in business? The woman can turn around the entire world, in business or not in business, she has to understand what is her woman's power. In business, the woman like the mother. In business, she relates to everyone like a mother. She has the innate qualities and strength in what? This kindness, understanding of the person, tactfulness. And let's say the woman is the boss. She shouldn't punish anyone herself. She should have some people around her who will be able to do that for her. She simply says, look, what can I do? I cannot cope with this person anyhow. She say that to somebody. Not like to her husband, she's saying this. No, she simply says, I don't really know, I'm confused. Any suggestions? Don't worry, I will figure out. And he fixing the problem. And after, let's say, she say to the person who had the problem, I didn't really mean that this happened, but obviously there was some difficulties. Perhaps it would make sense for you to change yourself so that people will change their attitude towards you. Maybe it would make sense to change your behavior. Just think about it. This. Of course, I understand this is difficult for you, but the people around you won't understand. The woman never waged the war directly, even on duty. She arranged the things in such a way that everyone will walk as silk. Need to know your nature, ladies. If she start to attack directly, the next will be a big problem. What is the behavior of the girl who wants to become a wife? The girl who wants to become a wife should work on herself. She should learn the humility in a relationship with people, learn the cordiality and kindness. She should not look at the guys. She should wear the simple dress. The girls are sitting and thinking, what a schizophrenic. What a schizophrenic. According to the Vedic knowledge, the good husband is guaranteed for the girl who wears the simple dress. And for the girls who dress themselves defiantly, loudly, the bad husband is guaranteed. I will explain. When the girl dresses herself very simply, then does she lose the woman's strength or not? No. Therefore, she will radiate the force that will attract the man, the guy, but will attract the guy who will appreciate her depth, not appearance, but her depth. And as a result, she will find a good husband for herself. But not at once, of course, the good lads do not lie about the road, right? They need to meet first. Meanwhile, she will accumulate strength in herself. Since the Vedic scriptures say the more woman opens her body to different men, the more she loses her beauty. Therefore, the woman should cover her body. Not only in ancient tradition, the women were not showing their bodies at all. The more woman opens up her body, the more she loses her strength. So she has to try not to show her body to anyone, and she will accumulate the strength in this way. And why you need the strength for? In order to attract an intelligent guy, that is the strength. And so she should behave in this way, and gradually she will find a good person. How to express your point of view humbly, if it is necessary, since his decision and action lead to negative consequence for everyone, and how to change his point of view so that he won't understand this. I was talking about this the entire lecture. If this concerns financial decision, I'm financier, he's not. Need to go home and say, you financier, I'm not. Come and say with the closed eyes, you financier, I'm not, your decision. Know that his decision will be your decision. Everything you decide, he will tell. If you will practice a tractable approach. First of all, the first stage, he will put his point of view. After you continue on with your tractable approach, actually the man is not interested about anything in his life. He not need the money, he does not need anything. All he need that somebody respect him. He does not give a damn about anything. Money, no problem, he can give money. Anything you want, he does not need anything else. He only need respect. The woman taking steps back further and further, there comes such a point when he does not give a damn about his finances anymore. He already thinks the way she thinks. That's it. Difficult to understand. If a girl or a guy start to know each other, the girl should behave the same way as in the family or not? No, not like in the family. Please, I will not answer this question. Listen carefully, a lecture about the creation of the family. Very serious, deep lecture, a lot of points here, required knowledge in order to create a family properly. If the woman always behave as you say, is it possible that the husband get tired of her because she is a crybaby? You need to giggle too. Why only to cry? For example, the husband has a good mood. What the wife should do? She should giggle joyfully somewhere in the next room. He's coming. And what are we laughing about? She's saying, I won't tell you. And smiling. She should be the first in all matters. The mood should be controlled by her. The husband has a good mood, she increases it. The husband has a bad mood, she feed him, quietly. The woman wrote that she is the widow. 7 years before the death of her husband, they were living separately. There are children, the boy 19 years old and the girl 14, how to behave. What is the problem? The boy 19, he's independent, the girl needs to be trained, but she is 14, she's grown up already, need to train her already not like her mother, but like a girlfriend, need to behave friendly with her. You should not make pressure on her. The boy should be considered senior. It doesn't mean that she, mother, considered him as senior as a husband. No, she just have a tractable approach, but she still remains his mother. The last word is up to her. Like one guy with his mother recently came to me, and he was asking his mother to ask how the mother should behave with the son if there is no husband. He was listening to the lecture. Actually, something he didn't quite understand. The mother always remains the mother, but she showing her strength through the weakness, through her weakness. She saying to him, "Why you are so irresponsible? I'm an unprotected woman of yours. Help me behave properly. Don't swear. Don't drink. I'm depending on you. Understand?" If in the family of friends there are serious problems, the husband drinks heavily, does it make sense to give advices if the wives themselves don't understand that this is their own fault? Will it harm my family? Not need to give advices to anybody. Try to understand such a thing that the first stage of understanding the lecture. If you're for the first time here, you don't understand the idea. You will have an urge to change everybody. Urge to educate your girlfriends. Don't waste your strength. It is better to direct it towards yourself. You didn't understand anything yet. Everything that you understand, you will forget in 5 minutes' time. You will go out and your mood will be changed. When you reach the bus stop, you will feel that it was some kind of hallucination, that it's not possible to live that way, that life is different, is much heavier. Your mood will be changed. Everything that you feel now is the power of the whole of this knowledge that already exists in the minds of many people. It weighs on your head and you think that this is mine now. I understood. Nothing of the kind. You don't know anything yet. This is just a superficial knowledge, external, just something that has come up to you a little bit. Therefore, not need to educate anybody. Don't waste your strength. The Vedas say the first phase of work on yourself is need to avoid undesirable association, means don't tell anybody the experience you've got in this lecture. If you want to share this with anybody, just invite this person to the lecture, not need to say anything, to prove. As soon as you start to prove something to anybody, and if this person starts arguing with you, since your sprout of knowledge is very weak, it will be ruined immediately. You will lose your enthusiasm at once. You will lose the desire to practice this knowledge. That's it. Not need to tell this anybody. Just do it quietly. Work on yourself. Study. You've given the field of activity a lot of work on yourself lie ahead. So just work, not need to consult with anybody, but consult with those who already attending these lectures. You will see that this will bring your strength. If you will try to change somebody of your close people, you will lose the strength. There is no doubt about it. What to do for those women who are separated and lonely with children? How to train yourself? What to do with the inspiration? Stay on our wave. We will have a lecture on this topic. Where you can learn about the prayers for protection of the husband. In your religious tradition, in every religious tradition there is such a prayers. Go to the church or the temple and they will tell you everything, whether it is Orthodox, Muslim, Jewish, what is your faith. Go there and they will tell you everything. How to get back the respect of the husband in case if I didn't behave properly in the past? Very simple. First of all, you need to conquer the weakness of heart and need to start to tolerate the impacts. As soon as you start to feel that I'm myself guilty in everything, next, start to act in such a way, as I've explained here, simply brazen-faced. Behave in such a way, as I've told you. This impudence will be accepted as a proper behavior. Very positively, don't worry, everyone will understand you. Can you explain, please, if the mother raised her son alone, she also should fight and argue on his behalf? Of course, the mother think of her son as the best, she saying, my son is the best, she relate to him like this. But the mother has the right to mention to her son humbly what he is doing wrong, in contrast to the relationship with the father. She saying to him, you know, if you would study better, you would feel happy. But she doing this in a humble mood because it is useless to pressure the man. In a very humble way, she's trying. He will listen to his mother. When the son will start to respect his mother, he can change himself tremendously. I am divorced, have a daughter. Using your words, run away from the battlefield. Can I create a family with another man? In order to create a family, it is necessary to have a strength. The woman becomes attractive if she develops the woman's feature and her character. She becomes beautiful, attractive. There comes in a strength to create a family. If you would be able to create a family, you would create it long time ago. Start to save your woman's strength. Behave womanly in relationship with the people. And the time will come. As soon as you get the strength, the man will appear at once. You not need to look for the man. He will appear himself. As the strength will come, the man will appear. Also, according to the fate, the person cannot create the strength, he is not capable to. Don't put the notes, I won't be able to. How to behave if my man is not able to forgive? I'm telling you, don't write such notes, please. Raise your hands, ladies, whose husbands able to forgive. You see only 20 people raise their hands. The man is not able to forgive, he is not capable to. If the man able to forgive, he always apologizes. Forgive me, I'm not right. How the woman will react on him? She will feel herself as a winner, but inside of her, she will think, what a weak person falls to my lot. I would rather find myself more cool person. What is the point to force the man to ask for forgiveness? Need to make a woman out of him. So you find a woman for yourself and live with a woman then. It's fashionable now. If you want to live with a man, why you need to wait? It is just not proper. Not need to wait when he say that he is not right. He will change himself without saying a word. If you will behave correctly, that's it. Could you tell me, please, how to feel the moment when you are ready to give birth to the children? It is difficult to say, because I am already forgot when I was in a woman's body. Now I will think. Now I will think, meditate on. When you are ready to give birth to the children, the favorable time for the childbirth of the woman is characterized by the following points. She feels that the relations in the family become subsided, the relations become better. Her illnesses has passed, especially woman's disorders, it's become less, and she is capable to work on herself. So those three principles indicate that now is the favorable situation for the childbirth. If the woman's illnesses become prominent, if the relations become worse in the family, if there is no strength to work on yourself, it is not a favorable time for the childbirth. You understand? The last question. Should I humbly listen to my husband if he wants to live together with his parents? They have a big house. How to overcome myself and adjust to this situation? In any case, you don't have a choice, ladies. You think you have a choice. If the husband wants to go to this house, what options you have? He make those decisions, you know. On the one hand, yes, the woman should first to break the relations with her husband, and after it will be easier for her to do something else, yes? On one hand, yes. But on the other hand, she don't have a choice. She cannot oppose her husband. It will be even worse. Therefore, as the fate go, let it go. Need to accept it. Everyone sit properly. Let us to wish the happiness to everybody. Everyone who is late, go home. Those who want to try to work on yourself, stay here. Feel free to go, those who are in a hurry. Now it is the right time. Now we will turn on the spiritual music, which will help us to tune properly. No matter what kind of spiritual tradition, important that this music should help. At home, it is better to turn on your music, your spiritual tradition. Why? So that it would not cause the protest of the close people. If you have your own traditions and faith, find some sublime music in your tradition and switch it on in your home. We are switching on this music here because I know this helps. I've tried it many times. Now we will practice. The practice consists of that all together we will repeat very seriously and attentively. Indeed, attentively, not emotionally, but attentively. I wish happiness to everyone. When we are repeating attentively, I wish happiness to everybody, our goal is to see the faults in ourselves, to see the faults in ourselves, and to see the nobility in the people around you. Generally, the person sees in himself the nobility and the faults in another person, and that is his misfortune. This is our misfortune. In order to become a fortunate person, so that indeed have an ability to influence on the situation, on the fate, the person must learn by desiring the happiness to everyone to see that he is actually has many shortcomings. But the people around him, they are very good people indeed, and need to improve yourself so that to be worth of these people. Those of you who will be able during the wishes of happiness to everybody enter into that state, they will open a new world for themselves. But most of the people won't be able to do so and not need to worry. Simply continue on wish happiness to everybody and gradually you will see that the life is changing. It is difficult to overcome the egoism for the person. To revive in the heart a true egoism and to overcome false, it is very difficult. Therefore, your shortcomings, even if you think that you have many of them, but in reality all this is just a baby talk. Indeed, a few people actually able to think and understand. But this direction is the right direction. Need to wish the happiness to all, not to yourself wish the happiness, but to all. On the contrary, you need to stop thinking about yourself, nothing to wish for yourself, nothing desire. Need to direct your mind on the others, and that is the idea of achieving the happy life. Let's start calmly and thoughtfully work on ourselves. The deepest method, the ancient method of self-realization, which you will hear right now, very simple and deep by its nature. If you are really will be able to achieve success in it, never nobody will be able to ruin your relationship with the people. In other words, you will be the king of your relationship. Everything will be all right with you. I wish the happiness to everybody. I wish the happiness to everybody. I wish the happiness to everybody.